Hi, I'm Terry, one of the Consumer Technology Specialists for Mid-Continent Public Library. And let's look at the menu bar and the toolbar in Google Sheets to see how they can work together and separately to help you create the spreadsheet that you want to use. To get started, I have already opened my browser of choice for the day, which happens to be Google Chrome, but you could use any other browser. And then I have a homepage of the Mid-Continent Public Library homepage website, and I would like to keep that on that tab just in case I need to come back and refer to it. So in the upper left, I'm going to go to the right of that tab and find a plus sign where I can click and open up a brand new tab. Now, to get started, I'm just going to type sheets.google.com and press enter. From here, because I haven't logged into Sheets or Docs or my Google account in general, it's asking me to choose an account and then get all signed in. Well, I have a lot of practice accounts, but I could go to this first one and click on it. And then it picks up my username, and then all I need to do is type in the password. If I'm not sure that I've typed it correctly, I can come over to the right where there's this eyeball, and I could click it and I could look to see if I have typed it correctly, but I think I have. Below where you type your password, if you've forgotten your password, you do have a way to find it and really more likely and generate a new one. But we're just going to go to the right here and click next. And then from here, it may open a new untitled spreadsheet, or it may, as I click on this icon for Sheets, it might take you to the Sheets home. But either way, you are now in Google Sheets. Now that we're at the Sheets home page, let's go up to the upper left where it says start a new spreadsheet, and let's find that blank template that has the multicolored plus sign and click, and that will open up a brand new sheet. Now, as we look at this, above the column letters, we have little bitty pictures or icons that run across the top of that sheet. And as we look at them, we might even be able to figure out that these icons or pictures are representing buttons, and each button has its own job that it does to help you create the spreadsheet that you want. If we look even more carefully, we can see little bitty vertical divider lines every once in a while. And what those divider lines do is they divide the buttons into different groups that have similar functions within a spreadsheet. So let's go to the far left and look at some of these buttons in more detail. Now, having said that the groups have similar functions, this very first group on the left really doesn't quite follow that pattern. So the very first two buttons here are undo and redo. Those are similar, but then we have the printer button. So it's just something that people use very commonly. If we had a spreadsheet here, we could click on this button and send the spreadsheet to the printer. To the right of that, we have a paint format button that lets you copy the formatting from one cell to another cell. And then we have the little divider line. So here we have a new group. And with this group, it says it's for zooming in. And really, zooming in just helps you with the view. So if you find your spreadsheet hard to read because the text is so small or the numbers are so small, then you can zoom in to a larger size. Let's click the drop down here and go to 125%. Now you may have noticed that while the cells and their rows and column headers have all changed in size, the toolbar here and the menu bar are still the same size. So this is just simply for your comfort as you work with Sheets. To the right of that, we have a number formatting group. So here's where you add in dollar signs, and really it'd be dollar signs and decimal places after a whole number. To the right of that, you can convert decimals to percents. The next two icons are very similar, just kind of work in opposite ways. One lets you increase the number of decimals in a number, the other one lets you decrease the amount of decimals in a number. And then the 1, 2, 3 button here is simply a more formats button where now you can go through and say, oh, I want to make all sorts of changes to the formatting and add not only, say, a currency format, but even date and time as well. Then to the right of that, we get into the characters, the font kinds of changes and formatting that we might want to do. So the very first choice here says Arial. Let me come to A1 and type, that would help, and type a word. And then let's go back to our default font of Arial. And we can see that these are fonts that I may have already used, but if I scroll down, we can see that there's a whole list that I can choose from. But I think I'm going to go with that permanent marker just for fun, and just that fast, I've changed that font, haven't I? Well, to the right of the font, we have 10, and that is the font size. Now, 10 is a little small. I believe I read one at some point that newspapers and magazines use 11 font, but some people will find that even a little uncomfortable. So you might decide to go to 12 instead. But again, that is up to you and how you see things and what makes you comfortable. So the 12 does make it a little larger. To the right of that, we can make this bold, italics, use a strike through. And then this A with the black underline says text color, but that seems a little misleading. Well, if I click on the A, oh, well, now I have all sorts of different colors that I could choose for the text. So let's go with, say, a darker blue. And I now have a dark blue instead of the black that was the default. And you can see that now that I've selected a cell with text color, that button has changed to reflect the color in that particular cell. To the right of that, we have a button that I always find a little hard to look at that icon and figure out what it means, but this is a background color. So I'm assuming that's like a paint pail or maybe a beaker of some kind, where when I click on that button, it also gives me color choices. And if I select something that I hope is relatively light, it will fill in the background of that cell with that color. To the right of that, we have a borders button, and borders are really important because as we look at this spreadsheet, we can see that we have lines that divide the cells. They are called grid lines, but they're a very light color and they don't print. So if I want to have actual definitive borders around my cells, I need to use borders instead. So I can click borders and then click on, say, this all borders button, and then click off, and you can see that now I very definitely have that cell outlined. That can be really helpful with your spreadsheets. To the right of that, we have icons that help you place the cell contents correctly within a cell. So let me go back to this one. And this lets me, as I go to horizontal alignment, I could left align those numbers or I could center those numbers instead of having them just right align as they do by default. The vertical line lets you move the contents of the cell to the top of the cell, the middle, or the bottom. Now, this works better if my row were a little bit taller to begin with. And then to the right of that, we have text wrapping that keeps the cell contents all within just one cell. To the right of that, we have something that can be very helpful, which is text rotation. So if you have a very large spreadsheet that goes out to the right for many, many columns, and yet you don't have much within the cells that are in the columns, it's just the headings that tend to be really wide. If you use text rotation, you can rotate those column headings and get more on a page. To the right of that, then, we can insert a link, a hyperlink, if we want to do that. We could insert a chart, which we don't really have numbers to reflect that, but to make your whole spreadsheet more visually understandable, we could insert a chart. We could create a filter that helps us find just the information that we want, and then we could also find functions that help us do the math that we need to make that spreadsheet work the best that it can be. Now that we've looked at the toolbar, we're going to take a little while and look at the menu bar, which is made of words instead of pictures. But here's something to keep in mind. While there are a lot of buttons on the toolbar, there are some that are also in the menu bar, while others can only be found just in the toolbar. By the same token, we are going to see things in the menu bar that are found in the toolbar, but other choices are only available in the menu bar. So it's up to you to decide, especially with those buttons that, you know, or choices that can be found either place, that, you know, you just look at where your mouse is, how you're feeling that day, what makes sense at the time, and choose the one that you would like to use at that time, while others you may need to memorize where you can find them. So with that in mind, let's go to File in the far left, and we could create a new document if we needed to, a new spreadsheet, a new presentation or form even. We could open an existing spreadsheet if we wanted to do that. We could email a spreadsheet, and we could even rename the one that we have right now. To the right of that, we have the edit choice. And with edit, we can see undo and redo, and those are the first two choices on the toolbar as well. But we have cut, copy, and paste, which are not on the toolbar, and yet a lot of people use them quite often. So you may want to remember where we found those in particular. To the right of that, we have view, and this is just how you see things in the spreadsheet. So it has turned on the grid lines and the formula bar already. Freeze can be a really nice help in that you can make sure that, say, the first row and the first column in your spreadsheet will remain stationary no matter how far you scroll to the right or scroll down. So this can be a great help. To the right of that, we have insert. And as we look at insert, we can see there are a lot of different ways that we can insert rows and columns. If we have an existing spreadsheet, this could be, again, a really nice tool to have. But then we see like chart and function and insert link that were also part of the toolbar with some other nice, more advanced features added there as well. Under format, there are a lot of choices, but a lot of repetition with the toolbar. So under number, there may be even more choices here, but look at all of these different number formats that we see and that we've mostly seen before. Below that, we have bold, italic, underline, strike through, font size, alignment, text wrapping, and text rotation that are all also on the toolbar. Again, we may have just maybe more choices within the menu bar. To the right of that, we have data, so we could sort our sheet alphabetically, which is a great help from time to time, create a filter, which we already saw, and then most of the rest of these options tend to be more advanced options that hopefully we will get to in the future. To the right of that, we have some tools, which are, again, are more for advanced users, like creating a form or writing macros or recording macros either way. But then here we have spell check, which just about anybody would be happy to have that as a tool. And then add-ons are interesting features Where if you know for a fact that you should be able to do something with a spreadsheet, especially if you've been able to do it in Excel and now you can't find out how to do that in Sheets, you may need to look at the add-ons, which are sort of like pre-created little tiny programs that have very specific jobs that help you do some of those tasks that you know you should be able to do, but you just can't find them in Sheets. And then, of course, there is help if you would like to have some answers to questions as you go through Sheets. For more information on Google Sheets, be sure to look for our online resources at mymcpl.org/online learning. There you'll find such great resources as Universal Class, lynda.com, Who Knew It, and Learning Express Library. Be sure to join us each week for a variety of tech topics. Join us on Facebook at MCPL360 on Tuesday at 2 or Wednesday and Friday at 1. If you happen to miss our Facebook premiere, or you just simply prefer YouTube, be sure to look for our MCPL MO channel, which has our MCPL Consumer Technology Resources playlist.